going to explain you to how to do the connections for second order low pass filter. Second order low pass filter. For this experiment, we require these components. One is function generator to give the input signal, and it is the power supply plus 12 minus 12 to bias the op amp, and we require resistors and capacitors, and it is a CRO for measuring the voltage. Here is the circuit diagram for second order low pass filter, and it is the design procedure. Here we have taken the cutoff frequency 4 kHz, and for second order filter the passband gain is 1.586, and it is the formula to find out the value of R. Suppose if you choose C, let C is equal to 0.01 microfarad, that is 103.01 microfarad. So here comes the R value, 3.9k for this given cutoff frequency 4 kHz, and non-inverting gain of op-amp is, this is the formula, and if you calculate the feedback resistance, that is 5.86, it will come around. Practically we choose 5.6k resistor, and it is the circuit diagram. Now I am going to show you how to do the circuit. It is an op-amp 741. It is having 8 pin. This is a pin number 1. It is here, it is a notch is there. So it is a pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The IC is MUA 741. Here it is a MUA 741. The first thing, I will bias the IC. Here in this power supply there is a readily voltage supplies the plus 12 and minus 12, hence this IC requires both the voltages, that is a minus 12 and plus 12. Minus 12 you need to give for pin number 4, plus 12 volts you need to give for pin number 7. Here I will show you how to do the connections. Here it is op amp. First I will connect minus 4 volts. Here it is the breadboard, normal breadboard we have taken. It is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 4 volts. And it is a plus 12. You need to give to pin number 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Pin number 7. And this common terminal. And this is common terminal we need to ground. Common terminal you need to make a ground. Here for our design we require two 3.9k resistors, and 10k for R1 and load resistance 10k, and then you need to connect two capacitors, and RF is 5.6k. Now I will do circuit connections as it is in the circuit diagram. Here 3.9k require two resistors, two capacitors, and 110k here at the load, and 110k R1 it is been grounded, and one feedback resistor, that is 5.6k. Now first, but from pin number 3 you need to connect two resistance in series. From pin number 3 I will take one resistor 3.9k and connect it to any open end, and another 3.9k resistors are taken from the same end point and leaving it as a open. Further we need to apply the input voltage for that point, and the capacitor, one capacitor you need to connect from between these two resistors point to pin number 6. In number 6, another capacitor it is being grounded from pin number 3 to ground. We have taken this line as a common ground, pin number 3 to and one 10k resistors from pin number 2 to ground. And 5.86 resistor here, it's practically 5.6, 2 to pin number 6 you have connected. And load resistors from pin number 6 to ground is pin number 6. Any one point I have given, we'll take a small wire from here to it has been grounded. So this entire line is ground, common point. I need to apply the input signal, the input voltage. Here the input voltage is 0.5 volts peak to peak. You need to set. I'll take, for this I will use the FG, that is a sine wave. It is for sine wave. To get 0.5 volts you need to go for 20 dB attenuation. This entire range 20 volts peak to peak, it is for 0 to 20 volts. 20 dB, if you press, the range is 0 to 2 volts peak to peak. 40 dB, the range becomes 0 to 0.2 volts peak to peak. Now I have to go for this attenuation. Since I need to give 0.5 volts peak to peak, 20 dB attenuation you go for and take a sine wave. Initially you check the signal across the CRO. Switch on the CRO. First I will check the input signal. You can use BNC to BNC, otherwise you can take these two probes and make it parallel on the breadboard and check it across the CRO. No signal, it has come across the CRO. Here it is at 0.5, and vertically signal is covered one division. That is what you are getting is 0.5 volts peak to peak signal, sine wave. You can adjust the amplitude here. Here it is at 0.5 into vertical division, that is 1 into 0.5, 0.5 volts it is there. Now you can apply this signal to the actual circuit. Now it is probe negative, it is being common ground. Positive of the probe you need to give at this point. Positive of the probe here in the circuit, it is there to the resistor. And on probe you can take and parallelly you connect to that point to check the input signal parallelly. So it is coming, input you are getting. Now to check the output, take the another probe, go for dual channel. and output it is available at pin number 6 of the op amp. This negative of the probe is common grounded. Here output I need to check at pin number 6. Now you are getting both the signals at a time by using this dual mode. It is your input signal and you are getting the output signal. Now to check the gain, since it is the ideal graph of low pass filter, initially comes the pass band, next comes the stop band, it is a frequency and it is a gain. In the pass band there is a voltage. Pass band gain, if you check, this pass band gain is AF is equal to V out by V in. Since our V in is 0.5 volts peak to peak and V naught we need to find out, AF that is 1.586. So if you cross multiply this, you should get that is 0.75 or 0.8 volts output in the passband region. Now switch on module power supply. Now switch on the power supply. Now here you can check the gain at the passband region. Here it is the input voltage, that is 0.5 volts, and output you are getting this much. Here output voltage, if you calculate, it is at 0.5, it is at 1.2, 1.4 into 0.5, 0.7 volts you are getting. Output at lower frequency, that is a frequency around 500 or 400 hertz. And if you go through the graph, initially the graph should be constant. Constant and decrease. This is the actual graph of low pass filter. Here see, if you increase the, goes on increasing the frequency, the amplitude of the output signal is constant. After that it will decreases. That means the desired cutoff frequency is 4 kHz. It has been constant and decrease. The voltage, if you want to check, you have to check that the lower band frequency. If you increase the frequency, the voltage that is constant and decreasing. So actually want to cut, calculate the cutoff frequency, you have to, after plotting the graph, you have to take minus 3 dB and you have to calculate the original cutoff frequency.